I've never really gotten sober before. Like,
it's terrifying, isn't it?
Yeah. I just want back my life. I want back my happiness. I just want back everything that drugs took away from me.
The last I spoke with Taylor, she appeared to be doing really well. But tragically, on January 22nd, we learned that she passed away.
Although we don't know exactly what happened, there are not words that can comfort this kind of pain and loss. It is always devastating to lose someone that we've worked so hard with and that we've seen make such good progress.
So how did it go today?
I'm nervous, tired, I'm worn out, but I'm gonna try to make it work. For myself, I'm doing it for my children, I'm doing it for my ex-wife, I'm doing it for everybody.
The fact that Brett came here is a tremendous accomplishment.
This is gonna be the start of my recovery and the start of me getting my life back.
He called me that weekend to let me know that it was pretty serious.
I think it's great that he died sober and he was able to get sober for 104 days.
He went to my last basketball game of the season and cheered me on. I was that close to making a basket.
They started to remember the father that raised them because, you know, he raised them most of their life.
I'm glad we did the intervention because I'm glad my dad didn't die an alcoholic. But he died a dad.
Of course, you know, it's easy to make that decision when there's no war, you know, going on.
We're sitting in front of a mosque at a dead still. Vehicle's off.
Is there some... Look at this guy coming up on the left. Look at this guy, right on the left.
Hold up now. Let's get a view of what we're looking at.
Definitely scary, you know. There was times that I was pretty sure I wasn't coming home, ever.
He did his job, he did what he had to do, but it hurt him to have to kill people.
We were woken up this morning at 4 o'clock. Three men on the lake arrived at the scene around 5 a.m. A couple of men tried to flee the scene. Shots started being fired. We had one local national, a gunshot wound to the right side of his head, brain matter falling out. Searched the area, no weapons, no munitions. They claimed to be fishermen. So, overall assessment of this morning was we shot a fisherman, and that's it.
Yeah, you know, I did it for a reason because they were the enemy, but they're all still people and they still all have feelings, so it kind of messes with me a lot.
Brad has had some rough years over in the desert. He's, you know, hung out with his buddies one day and played cards with them and then watched them die the next day.
The day before we were leaving, something happened to me that I'm still having trouble dealing with and understanding, and that was the death of Sergeant Deason.
Sergeant Deason was not only Brad's sergeant, but they became pretty good friends.
I was turning in my body armor, and Sergeant Deason was on patrol, and it was the last patrol to go out for our battery, and you know, it was no big deal. We thought it was gonna be boom, you know, get out there, get it done, get it over with, come back and we're all going home. No, that's not how it ended. They got hit by a parachute grenade in Adwar, Iraq. It blew a hole in his leg about 6 inches in diameter, and he bled out his carotid artery before anybody could even render any first aid. I tend to sit around and think about the whole incident and experience with Sergeant Deason. You know, why did Sergeant Deason have to die on the last day, and not the first day, or the middle day, or any other day except for the last day? You know, why? Why not me over him? You know, I would have rather went than him. Why should his wife and 2 kids have to live the rest of their life without him there? Why?
We'd always have a fun time. We went sledding all the time. Like, I had an amazing childhood.
Courtney, she had a friend. He lived in the same neighborhood as us. They did everything together. They were inseparable. And then one day, he was just gone. I don't know if I even realized that it had affected her as much as it had.
She was no longer quite the same outgoing, bubbly Courtney, more argumentative, less time with the animals, we noticed right away.
She would start like to skip school and stuff.
She was hanging out with kids that you didn't want her to hang out with because you knew that they were up to no good.
I was 10 when I started using drugs. First drug I started with was weed.
That's really where it started, and from there it kind of escalated.
Hi, Lawrence.
Hi, how's it going?
Hi, my name's Bert.
Nice to meet you.
Welcome in.
How long have you been drinking like this?
I only drink 1 or 2 drinks a day, but it's not every day.
If we can find just one thing that we can show him to make his life better, the rest of the denial is going to crumble like a house of cards.
I don't know what's going to happen. I don't know what they're going to be treating.
Do you think that you have an alcohol problem?
No, I don't think I have an alcohol problem.